Hey everybody, it's Ileane from Basic Blog Tips. Today I want to talk to you about YouTube, and I'm also going to challenge you to compare your results with mine. Well, let me explain a little bit more. In this video, we're going to take a look at YouTube annotations, and you probably know that YouTube now allows us partners to link back to an associated website and an annotation on our video. Well, in this video, I want to show you how you can track the effectiveness of those annotations. And more importantly, I want to show you how to find conversions from those YouTube annotations and from traffic that you're getting from YouTube. And when I say conversions, I'm going to use the simple conversion of people signing up to your email list if you're using Aweber. And stick around for the end of the video, guys. I'm going to show you how to increase those conversions as well. So right now we are in my YouTube analytics. Now, in order to see how successful your annotations are, you just come over on the left-hand side and towards the bottom, you click the link for annotations. Now, I'm assuming you guys know how to add annotations to your videos, but if not, I'm going to link you to a video right here that'll show you how to do that. Well, I want to take a look at how many annotations are being clicked. Unfortunately, YouTube doesn't display that information. They give you percentages, and to be honest, I used to be a math whiz, but right about now, I'm not about to sit down and figure out 1.77% based on the total amount of views or the amount of views for that time frame. I'll be honest, I really don't have time to figure that out. And it's okay, because I'm going to show you how to find the real number over in Google Analytics. Now follow along here, because in order for this to work, there's one important thing that you need to do, and that is to set up a goal in Google Analytics. It's not hard at all. I've shown you this before in a different video, but it's so simple, I'm going to show you how to do it again. Click on Admin. Click on the site. Click on Goals. Now, the simple goal to track is a URL goal. That's the thank you page that people are going to see after they have signed up for your email list. Now, you will set up a new goal if you don't have this set up already. So just click this where it has plus goals. That lets you know that you have another goal remaining. But I already have it set up, so I'm just going to show you what it looks like. Just make a name for your goal. Of course, you want it to be active. You want your goal type to be the URL destination. Then you're going to include that forward slash and the name of the page. In this case, it's going to be thank you. Now, hopefully you have a thank you page already set up. You're going to say that it's going to have a head match. You don't want to use exact match, just in case there's any URL parameters or any funky code at the end. And don't worry about regular expression match. Okay, that's for e-commerce sites. Okay, assign a value to the goal. I just put $1 there. You can put any value you want, but I wouldn't use less than $1. You can set up funnels if you want, but we're going to keep this real simple. And just to review here, we're going to give it a name, make it active, URL destination, forward slash thank dash you, and head match. Goal value, and that's it. Save it. Now go up to the top of the page and click the link for reporting. Okay, this is where you're going to see your reports in Google Analytics. Stay with me, okay, guys? Let's go on traffic sources and sources and referrals. You don't need all traffic because we know a lot of that traffic is coming from Google. So let's just go into the referrals because we're tracking YouTube, remember? In the referrals, you'll see here, YouTube. Click that on. Now, I don't want to go too fast because I know this page is probably pretty intriguing to some of you guys if you haven't really dug into your Google Analytics. If you're using YouTube, you must check this page, okay? So you can see just how much traffic you're getting and if that traffic is converting. All right. So now, notice that it says watch. What that means, guys, is the watch page for a specific video. So it's not your channel page. It's the individual video watch page. Okay, let's try something because I want you guys to do this too. This is part of your challenge. Go up to the top and change the date range. And the reason I want you to do this is because remember, YouTube changed the channel and they switched over to one channel, which I did. I don't know if you did or not, but I just want you to grab a bigger date range. So I started with January the 1st. So now let's scroll down and take a look here from the watch page of the individual videos. I've got 380 visits. Then there's my channel page. There was only 6 visits. And looky here, my video annotate. So we're talking about YouTube annotations sending a total of 5 visits. Then here's another one that I guess represents my channel page, probably from a different layout and some other miscellaneous ones. All right, so let's look at the one that we are really interested in, which is the ones from the watch page. Now, this is the challenge that I have for you guys, because I told you a long time ago to always put your URL at the beginning of your description. Now, that's the link that people are going to. I already gave away my little secret. I said I was going to hold for the end. Oh, no, I didn't. I'm sorry. There's more to that secret. But wait, I'm getting ahead of myself. Hang on. Let's click on this segment, which is people that came from the watch page, which means they clicked on that link in the description, because there's no other link on the watch page. You don't see my blog URL and all that stuff like you do on the channel page, okay? Because you're only on the watch page. All right, let's get that straight. Okay, so now, one more thing, let's go into a secondary dimension. In this case, we're going to say landing page. So this is going to tell us exactly what page people landed on when they did come to my blog from that watch page. And this is when it gets really interesting. Okay, here we go. A lot, or the vast majority of people went to my homepage. But there's also these other individual videos. Let's see, I have 46 results here, where I have also included a link back to the video, back to the blog post. If there was a blog post for that video, I included. So you see a lot of ones and twos and so forth on down the line that go back to specific blog posts, because that was also included in the description. But notice that these are much more effective than the video annotations. Okay, now here we go. The final proof is in the pudding. We're going to look at our goals. Remember, the goals are how many people got to that thank you page when they signed up for my AWeber email list. So you click on goal set one, because that's where that thank you page is located. Aha! There are some people signing up. Let's even sort it in reverse order. And here you go. This is my little secret tip that I was saving for the very end. In February, I started using a page called Blogging Tips. That's the page I started off this video on. And I started adding that to my descriptions instead of my blog URL. And I really wanted to bring people to this page because this is my pillar content. I created this page. I embedded 5 of my podcast episodes here that go in a sequential order, telling people how to get started with blogging, how to start with their going into their webmaster tools, how to start building their email lists, and also how to promote their blog posts. Then I also have an additional bonus video on this page. Okay, so now this page is converting really well. Let's go back to Google Analytics, and you'll see that's a 5.88% conversion rate from those people. Even though right now it's only 17 visits, but that's okay. That's a good enough number for me to know that it's a better conversion than me just using my blog link. Because you got to remember, I am including no calls to action in my videos that say, go to my blogging tips page. If anything, I say, go to basicblogtips.com. Now, in this video, of course, I'm telling you, go to my blogging tips page. I just showed it to you. But most of the videos, I'm not saying that. I'm not including that call to action, and I'm not including an annotation to send people to that page. And I'll give you an example. Here's a video that's very, very popular, and it's about Google Chrome Toolbar and managing your Chrome extensions. You can see here I have over 7,500 views on this video, and I just recently changed it from just basicblogtips.com to blogging tips. There's something about seeing that extra blogging tips there. People know that it's not just my blog homepage. It's a page that has additional information. Sign up for my newsletter. That way you can stay on top of all the latest with blogging, social media, YouTube, and podcasting. And in order to sign up, just go over to basicblogtips.com/email. And I'll chat with you soon.